Hello, Crackers again, third thrilling instalment. This time not twine, no, let's use something else. And why? Because here, look, we have a 3-foot snake whip with a leather fall and an alum tanned deerskin cracker. Now this stuff is made by a mate of mine to a 16th century Venetian recipe. It's first of all squelched through with aluminium sulfate and salt, and then it's trodden through with flour and olive oil. Don't know why, but there you go. Right, this stuff is really strong because it's essentially treated rawhide rather than being actual tanned leather. And a cracker off this. Quite variable thickness stuff makes for a soft and non-abrasive, note that, there might be a reason for that, and not desperately loud cracker. Now you can use one of them and just cut a strip more or less. Well, correction, more, not less, because it will stretch and you'll want to trim it off. If you haven't got one of them, or a really nice knife, you use your pocket knife. Yeah, I think that was £6.95. Cold steel, made in China, Krupp 4116 steel, and as you can see, it's sharp enough to go through a dry thumbnail. Because if you really want to learn how to, if you really want a sharp knife, the old hair cutting test will only carry you so far. Because that tests the very edge. It tests just a little bit back from the edge, thumbnail. Anyway, it's easier actually to sit down to do this. This is like strand cutting anywhere. You have your strand, you have your knife, you stick that up there. You could use a thumbnail if you want a narrow strand. I prefer using the ball of my thumb. And about that wide. I'm not going to taper the strand at this point because right now I don't know whether the far end or the near end is stretchier or the thicker when it's all being tensioned up. So I want to cut about 1.5 times as much as I reckon I'm going to need. There we go. And try and point this thing the right. You know, these little cameras should come with little brass crosshair sights, steampunk style. Make life easier. Having got your trusty bit here, that's a thick one, and your trusty bit here, there's a thin one. Give it a little stretch to see what exactly you have. This one's really thin. I'm gonna have to chop this here. That's handy. Another Stanley knife, this time with a chisel blade in it. It cost about £3. And simply put a little slit in the end. And there you go, one cracker. That one turned out fine, just as it is, and that will go on that whip. And this fellow, as you can see, it's got a wide pit patch there, not so wide there, but from the feel of it, it's getting thinner towards that end. That's the pointy end, that's the blunt end. Jolly good, chop the end off there. Chisel a little hole. You can actually use a chisel. In fact, you can use anything that's more or less sharp. Just about use my teeth on one occasion. Okay, you've got your little loop. Put that in there. Bit of a stretch. Now here's where a right good sharp blade like your Mora comes in very handy. Get a little grease off it. And a bit of leather to save your finger. Pairing strands. I mean, this is what you do for bullwhips. You knock the corners off the strands. In this case, it's not knocking the corners off, it's knocking a bit of width off, possibly knocking a bit of thickness off, but It's one of those skills that you really need to learn, because if you say you're dropping a strand, chunky bullwhip, quite thick, quite white strands, you're dropping a strand, it's a good idea to mark it. You pull it tight, you fold it in, you mark it, you unfold it, trim it down. So learning how to wield a single blade is very worth the effort. Oh yeah, practice first. If you're not good at this, hold it the other way up. So spine it down, and you slide it between your thumb and finger like this. Hang on, are you pointing the right way? I'm not doing this again. Slide it between your thumb and finger. Now notice if it, sometimes it has a tendency to chatter like this. Okay, no worries. You break out your pot of grease or plaiting soap. Stick your thumb in it. Little dot of stuff on your thumb. Bit on the leather there. And now you are lubricated, and that will slide through in a more predictable fashion. As it slides through, you can feel it get wider and narrower and thicker and thinner. So taking, say, this edge, the right-hand edge, as my point of reference, I'm feeling that on the underside of my thumb as I'm running the strand through like that. So the bottom edge is staying pretty much still relative to my thumb, while the upper edge is moving up and down. So to practice, I start moving it, and then I bring the edge down like so. Once you've had a bit of practice, use the real edge. Get a little momentum up and then bring the edge down to join the leather. And if you want to taper it, just keep moving the bottom edge close to the top edge. When I say just, what I mean is practice, 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 then just. Because it's a ticklish business. This is the kind of thing that you practice with cheap leather first. That's a bit of width taken off it, and a little bit of taper imparted to it. Now it's bulging here. It's a bit thicker here. So here's where you need to build up a little speed and just shave off a bit of thickness. Like that. Try again. Actually, let's be sensible and turn this round, flesh side up. So once again, knife just above the leather and run it through the hands, then bring the knife down. And as you can see, you're taking little bits of shaving off all the way. Well, wherever it's needed. So you're holding your two hands in a constant sort of fashion, or a predictable fashion, relative to each other while running the leather through. There you go, that is it. That's how to make crackers out of alum tanned deer skin, if you are lucky enough to lay your hands on some. However, if you're not, chamois. Make sure it is actual chamois, not sheepskin masquerading as chamois, which is really quite weak. But this stuff from Whole Foods, a big chunk of it like that, is around about 12 to 15 quid, as far as I recall. And 120 crackers, something like that. And all you do is grab a straight edge. And first thing to do, having dressed them, even up the camera so you can see where I am. Yeah, first thing to do is to cut a little parallel strip like this, no taper at all. Here's where having a rotary cutter is a doddle. You got your strip like that, and making sure you know which end is which, give it a bit of a pull. Oh, hello. There's a characteristic worth noting. It's, with an even sort of a pull, it's wider at one end than it is at the other. It's also a smidgen thicker at one end than the other. Right, good. I've already got built-in taper. That means I put a little bit more in, but not too much on account of the stretch. And there you go, what's that? I don't know. It's about 8 mils. That's about 5.5. And for the princely sum of next to nothing, and all of half a minute's work, you have a cracker. Right, of the two, if you want to make not very much noise, then these are brilliant. And if you want to do not too much damage, these are brilliant. Well, yeah, if you want to do damage, you just use Dyneema, okay? But these two will... Oh, I'll show you. Might as well. Right, this is... what's that? That's it's an old alum... Actually, it's quite a new alum tanned cracker. Deerskin cracker. Now, I don't know what the sound is like on this little camera. That probably came across as a snap, but I still have my eardrums all as well. Now the chamois cracker. Let's see what that sounds like. These handle quite well on this fall. This might not have enough weight to handle quite as well. But the use to which such small whips is put is the kind of use that you would gravitate towards towards a leather cracker for. Bit louder. Little bit louder. I have tried kangaroo skin for crackers, but it's a very high-pitched sound and it cuts like a razor, so if you catch yourself with it, you're going to end up with a nick. And it comes apart. So, untanned, treated, preserved, natural materials. In fact, if you get Finnish kangaroo rawhide, that might be perfect. Don't know. If you find out, let me know. Cheers!